Hello again and welcome to Paul's Racing Channel and to the Ultimate Racing League. So this is round two of our BTCC GR4 Championship and we stay in the UK for this next one and to Goodwood in West Sussex down there in the south of England. The circuit itself is 2.3 miles clockwise and used to be an old World War II airfield before being converted into a racing circuit around the perimeter of the land. Now, it consists mostly of high speed corners, but it has got a really tight, challenging chicane at the end. So look out for lots of fun and games at that point with the drivers. A little bit of care will have to be taken to get through there without making a mistake. So for anyone new to this who didn't join us for round one, it's all a Mazda championship between Mazda 3s, or split between Mazda 3s and the Mazda Atenzas. Each teammate is in one or the other of the cars, and 3 15-minute races. Race one's about to start. Tyre compounds or tyre regs is that you have to run a soft tyre in one of the three and mediums in the other two, but you can do that in whichever order you like. Now, I'll go through the points next time round, being that we're only one round in, so it's early days in that, so I will run through them next time around. And I think it's time to get on with this first race, don't you? So we'll go through the grid, and on pole position you can see for yourself is Motorstorm Hero. We've got Stormfly in second, our victor from round one. I think he got a hat-trick actually of victories in that race. I've certainly got a double for sure. And we've got Fitzy in third, Osmond in fourth, James Stephen in fifth, Wacky Racer in sixth, Dizzy Rip in seventh, myself Paul in eighth, White Van Man in 9th, GMAC in 10th, Idle 4 Gaming in 11th. He wasn't there for round one, so welcome to him in this one. Willard in 12th, Archer in 13th, Brian Carney 14th, and Potsy in 15th. Right, that's it then. We had a little bit of difficulty with the normally as rolling starts in our championships, but for some reason we was having a few technical issues with the rolling starts. We did give it a couple of goes, but it weren't having it, so for this race one anyway, we had to do a back to the old grid starts, which didn't really work out that well in the end. So you'll see what I mean as we get rounds turned one and two. So let's go. Here we go. So note Storm Hero then. In fact, look, sits in first and he's about eighth there, so it's all screwed up already in terms of where people are. So. Oh, and there goes Stormfly, gets nudged out, and this is where all the commotion starts. We've got Stormfly out there, right out on the grass, then we've got a little bit of everything going on. Wacky Racer, Mr. Gear or something now, and he really slowed. Everyone goes streaming past him, and he's back to, what, eighth now? That takes up the lead for Fitzy then, in the Pertec livery car. Just to reiterate, this is the BTCC, or replica BTCC Championship, so the liveries you see are all was from the BTCC Championship over the years. As they come through now along Levante straight. Yet to even break, I don't think. Maybe a little tap of brake on a couple of the corners here, but pretty much full speed ahead all the way around as we now come to this tricky chicane for the first time. This right hander. Now here we go. Got a lovely flower beds there, but it's a bitch to get through at times. You've got to be really, really careful. But everyone did actually get through there nicely. Not anyone went over the grass either, so actually really done quite well there with all the drivers there. So Fitzy then on the soft tyres out front with Dizzy Rip following him. Actually his teammate, isn't it? It's his one on two for the Pertec, Team Pertec at the moment. So Dizzy Rip in second also, or we'll say also, is on the medium tyres. James Stephen in third, mediums. Putting pressure under Dizzy now. Now the trouble with the grid start was that the Atenzas are all four-wheel drive cars, whereas the Mazda 3s are front-wheel drive. So clearly the Atenza had the advantage off the grid there, which is why it all got a little bit... Paul went over in the grass here. Did actually run it a bit wide. Let's just have a quick look. Yeah, I struggled with this corner, to be fair. don't know why, I just couldn't knack it, but actually it was on the exit and I just ran it off, didn't I? So I'm not too sure what I'd done actually there. I don't know where there was, don't know really. Anyway, had to sit for a go. Mikey there in seventh. Fitzy still leading it as this James Stephen battle with Dizzy goes on as James goes around the outside. Good move there into chicane, so it's up to second place. This is where like the traffic jam forms through here. Great drone shot down looking at the chicane as we go through the field all the way back to Motor Stormy Hero in 15th. So from first to 15th, although he wasn't actually first, was he? Motor Stormy Hero, I don't think he had the best of races here. Struggled a little bit. We know he's a quick driver, but Archer, is he taking it back of Potsy as Motor Stormy Hero now looks on the outside of Archer. As we pan out of the camera, it's not much good here with the camera being like that as we see him going in off into the distance into the cornfield, and Motor Stormy Hero still, yeah, just about getting ahead of Archer there. So up to 14th he goes, Potsy just ahead of him in 13th. It's probably the only first time you break here on this circuit through that left hander. Easy to run it off, as you can see, lots of runoff in this track, but the runoff itself, unfortunately, is the farmer's field. So you do get yourself out there, you'll gonna take you a while to get back on, that's for sure, and you'll be losing heaps of time and positions. So James second, Dizzy Whip third, Osman fourth, G Mack in fifth, who runs it out onto the dirt. Stormflight up to sixth now, Paul in seventh, we've got Wacky in eighth. So come through across the line, start lap four. Fitzy, our leader, 1:15.0 at the moment, is the fastest lap. And well, look at the lead he's got. Absolutely. Leaving them for dead at the minute. Brian Moncarney in ninth. The Halfords car. Got Idle Four game in. As I say, he missed the first round, so it's good to see him back. We know, of course, quite a lot about Idle Four game. We've seen a lot of him on my channel in the various leagues, so we know what he's all about. He's out in 10th ahead of Willard in 11th. Team Lotus. Can't. Lotus Storm Hero. Oh, and that's an unconventional way of getting around there, but he's going to lose 12th spot. See what happened there. I think it was just pure acceleration, wasn't it? Let's see as he was coming around. Just flip that inside there. And was it the curb that done it, or did he? Oh no, he got his back well on the grass. Yeah, and it's a lovely drift, I've got to say. Almost caught it as well, but just loses one spot to White Van Man. So back to 13th, but yeah, lovely bit of drifting there from Motor Storm Hero. Archer in 14th, from Potsy now in 15th. Two Mazda 3s at the back there. At the front, there's another Mazda 3, and this one, car number 99. Mr. Fitzy himself is drawing life out there at the minute. Clean as you whistle through there. And he's you'll see the gap now. There is the gap if you look up the top of your screen. So he's got a lovely lead over James Stephen and Dizzy Whip. And then Osman, Stormfly now having a battle. Stormfly up the inside of Osman there, turn one. Edgewick, and that's a great pass there from Stormfly. Mazda 3s are quick in a straight line, and then G-Mac piling on the pressure on Paul, and he also goes up the inside of Paul through the little right-hander there, through the kink. So Paul back to 7th, G-Mac up to 6th. No one who's has gone off. Someone's gone off big time out there, big style. Who was that? Can't even see. Where did it go, is it? I don't even know who that was. Was that Dizzy, wasn't it? Let's have a look. Looked like a blue car. Oh, and he got spun round, didn't he? Big time there. Let's have a look again. So he's actually in third at this point. So you have Stormfly and Osman behind him. I don't think any of them was involved. Did he do it? He did exactly the same as Motor Storm, and he tried to correct it, come back across. Oh, and almost took the front of Stormfly's nose right off there. But he gets a reset and he loses, goes right back to 10th place. 11th place, 12th place, 13th place. He's still got dirt on his tyres, so back to 13th. So one of the attenders just getting their back wheels, back right hand wheel on the grass, and that's sending them across the other side of the track. So that's a couple of cars that have done that, haven't they? Osman has got back past Stormfly. Where did he make that move? It's quite a while then, because we see him, Stormfly take Osman, didn't he? But Osman obviously, I think, must have got him along. Maybe got himself in a slip. It's a little bit of a slipstream effect here as well, being that it's a quick track as well. So not only do you have this fast-paced circuit, add in the mix a little bit of slipstream. Very little braking, and you can see why. This circuit is a quick one. So Motorstorm still looking at Osman. Oh, and he's up the inside of him now, going along. Now, this front straight. Now we're gonna hit that right hand, clipping that inside curb, not too much of it though. Stormfly takes it, and they're getting very close to the edge of that curb, trying to open up the left hander. Got to be careful. We've seen it already with a couple of the cars, haven't we? The back, oh, Paul nearly got his back wheel on the grass there, ahead of Wacky Racer, but still there. He's Paul in sixth place. But Wacky up the inside now, a little gap opened. He just got his nose up there, and side by side, these two coming up the back straight now. Still got sixth, but he's going to be on the wrong side coming up to the right-hander, double right-hander here. Oh, but Paul broke a bit later, but he's going to lose it because he's going to run a bit wide, and Wacky knew that was going to happen, and he just stayed where he was and then just switched it back up the inside. Through the chicane they go. Brian there in eighth and crossing the line to start lap seven. To be honest, it was best night for myself as I run wide again. Boot clipping, I'll get front damage there. And, just couldn't get into the swing of things at all. As you'll see by from where I end up finishing in the races, but I'm on the soft, remember, and it's just, sorry, I'm on the mediums here in this first race, and even on the softs of struggling. So Brian's now taking him on seventh. And, oh, still gets there though, Brian, and now calls Motorstorm right behind me as well now. That damage, remember, that's all gone now. The tyres were wearing as well, and look, just couldn't get it turned. Motorstorm up the inside. It's like I was standing still at this point. Absolutely getting swallowed up by everybody. Idle 4 was coming. Teammate White Van Man also was coming behind me, and yeah, it was very difficult at this point to try and get back into. It's all about rhythm around here, that's for sure. You lose it for 1 second, and that'll throw you off. When that's that going off as Idle 4 Gaming. He's taking a lot of grass there. He loses a spot to White Van Man. So back to 11th he goes, and Willard. Easy to get a lot of grass on the exit as well through that chicane. Closes up. It's very narrow through there. Archer 13th. Potsy 14th, and Dizzy all the way back to 15th after. Having his off and then running it wide, and he's still running it wide. And as I say, it's all about rhythm. Once you lose it, it's a major effect. Because of the pace, the cars just go, they just leave you behind. Because it's so quick, you don't catch them up in any braking zones because there's not many. So Fitzy, our leader, he's got no such worries. He's got a lovely lead, still over James, who's in second, but Osman's up to third with Stormfly fourth, and they're coming and are catching James. And I think this is, where are we? We've come up to 10 minutes now, so 2/3 of the way through. And this is going to be hotting up here at the end of this race, that's for sure. If these two grab onto the back of James, we could be in for a thriller for the podium places. And G-Max not that far behind either, in fifth. There he is. And Wacky in sixth. G-Mac there in 5th, Stormfly 4th. Stormfly is our leader of the championship after one round. Obviously having that double, that good start around Brands Hatch. So obviously he's going to be leading the current table. And he's also got that fastest lap as well now. Fitzy, a 115.0. I mean, pretty much bang on there, isn't it? A 115, dead. Let's just call it. Some of these drivers were getting into the 14s. Definitely 14s were possible out there. Don't know whether they did it, if anyone did get into the 14s in this race, but anyway, Stormfly's coming. Their fastest lap, and they're right on the back of James now. Look at this. One small mistake, especially through that area, and losing that. Great exit from Stormfly. Is going to get a run on Osmond, but Osmond's going to stay to the right-hand side for this first right-hander. I mean, that Stormfly's on the outside, and that's not where you want to be. Not a turn one, but he gets round. Lovely. What a pass that is. Just kept it foot down, and let's have a look at that. Fabio's gone bald with Stormfly. He gets this run on Osmond on the outside now. Osmond now, and as they come along into turn one, let's have a look. He's almost passed him there, but he stays clinging onto the outside, just keeps the keeps it steady. You can see Osmond there in the mirror. It's a great move, Stormfly, to take third position off of Osmond. Give James a little bit of relief because of them fighting, but still not that far ahead, is he, James? So he's still got a little bit of pressure from behind. The tyres on these front wheel cars as well, especially around something like this, they did wear very quickly, even on these short sprint races, 15 minutes. Some worse than others, of course. Osmond now in fourth, he was on the softs. G-Mac in the mediums in fifth still. Overstorm Hero in sixth. But let's go back to this battle, because I think Stormfly, let's see what sort of exit he will get now. See if he can pull the same move on James as he did just a minute ago on Osmond. Well, James got it right through there, so he's not going to line himself up the same place. Although, having said that, he is right behind him again, isn't he, Stormfly? But he's not in a position to pass. Not this time, not at turn one anyway, so maybe along this front straight. Get into the slipstream. Here we go. As we pan out and look across the cornfields to the back of the cars as they go through the kink and along. Now, he's looking. Stormfly, surely you can't go any outside there. Now, that's a brave move. I mean, if you do, you're on the inside for the next one there, the left-hander, but yeah, never going to happen there. Never. Not even for the best of them. And Osmond still just sitting there in fourth, just hanging on to see what little bits he can make up. And Stormfly does grab the inside of James. It's another good move from Stormfly. So gets himself through. So James loses that second place and Stormfly's there, but James is still attacking him. Meanwhile, Fitz is loving this, but so when James does, he does do what Stormfly done, but he goes around the outside. Good racing now. So James does get it back. We're into the last minute now, so it's all gathering up nicely here. Fortunately, we haven't had time to look at many of the other cars in this race, have we? This is where the battles are going on. I mean, there's a lot of things going on behind. Let's just have a look. Another battle there is Willard, I think, just got past game. Idle Ford Gaming. Let's just have a quick look just to see. He was in ninth. Idle's in seventh and Brian's in eighth. So what happened here then? Because Willard then got past Idle. Did someone go wide? Oh, he did. There he goes. Idle Ford Gaming. Where was he? There he is. Out there on the grass. That allowed Willard to get through. Brian obviously got through as well. Back to ninth he goes, and then Archer's right behind him as well now. 10th place is going to take Idle Ford Gaming as well, or at least he's going to look for it. Willard's got half a second. But our leader, see, he's on the last lap. There's the other battle for second. It's still James holding off Stormfly and Osmond, but this is could well be the final lap for Fitzy and Co. And as we now go up the back straight, Levante straight, and to the last 10 seconds of this race, so it's certainly going to be the final lap. And this is still going on, this battle for second place, second and third place. Stormfly on the outside, he's going to do a repeat of what James done, is going to go around the outside, but is he going to make it work? James isn't letting him have it, there's no way he's going to let him have it. Final lap it is, as he comes through the chicane, as we go back to our leader. Here we go, it's Fitzy, who's led from the start. Look at this. put himself out in front, and congratulations to him. Wins race one, and then it is James from Stormfly from Osman, fourth. Motorstorm up to fifth. So G-Mac just lost a place to Motorstorm in the end, so fifth for him. G-Mac will come in sixth. Brian McCarney, seventh. Archer in eighth. Willard in ninth. Will he get done by Paul? No, look at this, is going to be close. No, it's close on the line there. Willard ninth. Paul 10th. White Van Man 11th. Idle Four Game in 12th. Wacky in 13th. Potsy will come in 14th. Dizzy finishing 15th. So there's your race one here from Goodwood. Join me for races 2 and 3 again. Hope to see you, and thanks for watching. Bye for now.